Hey, it's Necktie. Welcome to episode 21 of Going Old School. And in this one, we're going to start out by heading back up to Laredo. Let's get into it. And hopefully this damn game doesn't crash again. I have no idea what's going on with OBS in this game. But anywho, we're down here in Brownsville. So we're going to come out of Maersk, hang a left out of the gate, because this is the gate. So we're going to hang a left out of here, and then we're going to take the first right past the Walmart, get on 69 East North. Going to take the 2 exit, basically stay on that. That turns into 83. Then in Laredo, that turns into I-35 North. And if I wrote this down right, it appears this is going to be a rough one. Because I can't tell by this if this curves around or if this comes off and curves around and this goes straight. And I'm assuming that one of these goes over the other sort of thing. So I have written down to take the second right at the interchange. Or no, not. I'm getting ahead of myself. I have written down to take the second exit at the 69 interchange. So exit one, this one. Stay on the frontage road and then take the second right after the interchange. First right and follow in. So we shall see. And as you can see up there, I have a World of Trucks contract. Oh, we're doing good. Didn't crash. And for those interested, 36,000, almost 37,000 pounds of office supplies. And also, since it was a World of Trucks contract, I didn't have to check in. I just had to go around and back up to here because that's where we unloaded over there yesterday. So that is all you missed, folks. Exciting shit, isn't it? And I guess I can delete that. There we go. So, all right. And I'm going to write this down that we are starting our day at 07:30 is what I'll say we started it at. Oh, also, we have 29 cities knocked off, and I was looking at the map today in Texas, and I was like, wait a minute, something isn't adding up. So we had 199 cities total, and I missed one, so actually we have 200 cities. I missed one of the Matt VT yards. All right, gate, let's go. So yeah, so far we're, apparently I scraped that gate a little bit. Anyway, where the hell were you, Ty? We have 29 of 200. So I need to hang a left at this sign up here to go back out the gate. Thank you. hanging a left. Oh, green light. Look at me go. I've written down to take the first right, but I don't think that's the right I wanted. Watch it be the right I wanted. Nope. Good. And I was in the wrong gear. To have your range selector and splitter in the right position. I'm gonna say this was it. Yep, 69 East North. So far, so good. Now we just need 2 west, which should probably have a sign that says 83 as well. I don't know. And this is it right here. Yep. 283. Perfect. Hopefully there's something up to San Angelo out of there. Get that knocked out, and then all we have is Fort Stockton, Pecos, Odessa, Van Horn, and El Paso, all on the east side there. Hoping I can get those knocked out fairly quick as well, because no offense, but I'm getting sick of Texas. as I'm sure some of y'all are as well. And I didn't plan on staying in Texas this long, just kind of how it worked out. Plus, it's a big-ass state. I should probably think about getting some fuel when I get to Laredo as well. All right, is this the 69 interchange already? Okay, so that was the first one, which goes over. Okay, perfect. And then, okay, I'm going with what I said. Second exit, and then I stay in the frontage road. Take second exit at 69 interchange, which I did, and your light's not green tie, that's the one up there. Follow frontage road. Second right after interchange. There's a Union Pacific sign. Which is a good sign, no pun intended. Oh, it's just a billboard. Well, either way. There's our first right. I could have taken that one. Union Pacific. Look at me go. Check, nothing major. Thank you. Alright, am I blind again? Nope, it's right there. Now the question is, do I want to lift that rear axle or not? Let's try it one more time. Why not? I'm gonna try and pay more attention to this UPS trailer than I am that white flashing line too, and see if that helps my depth perception in this view any better. Well, it appears it may have a little bit. How did I not hit this other trailer? I mean, I'm not complaining, but holy crap, I gotta be close to it. Hey, camera, if you would... Holy shit, man. I really wish, too, that if you had some type of head tracking, that the SCS camera would not fight you. And maybe I'm just an idiot and other people don't have this problem, which is very plausible. We made it. Basically a 5-hour trip. 219 miles. Means it was roughly a 40 mile per hour average. Brain fade is trying to figure out what the hell button I had to hit. More importantly, that is number 30 of 200 marked off the list. Laredo. I'm gone. Alright, now let's see. Please be something coming out. One frickin' load. Oh, for the external market. Okay. Now, San Angelo would be nice. So basically we have one, two, so we have El Paso, Van Horn, Pecos, Fort Stockton, Odessa, and San Angelo. We've actually discovered San Angelo, we just didn't deliver there, so let's see if... So then, is there anything to... No, there's nothing. Odessa. Alright, fine, we'll go to Odessa then. Cargo is ready to be loaded, and I have to go. Wait a minute, set head towards the flag. Do I still need to check in? Alright, well, I'm not seeing. I mean, I didn't get in there too bad. Oh, it's over there. Alright. So let's lift that axle. I'll stay in this view. First of all, I need to release the brake. I'm gonna stay in this view so I can show y'all what I'm doing. But I'm gonna spin to the right. I could do it with the axle down too, but we're gonna come out here and hug this trailer. I didn't exactly want that view, but yeah, see, I'm not even touching that. That's SCS cameras for you. Apparently that container's a collision, so it just wants to zoom on its own. Is what it is. All right, there you go. Just in case anybody was wondering if you could actually do that. As much work as I put into this trailer for this paint skin, I'm kind of looking forward to getting rid of the damn thing. I'm not a fan of how it behaves at all. It's a damn good trailer though. And I am way off. What in the hell, man? Okay, so apparently I need to turn the auto position back on because I don't feel like the head tracking does this with the auto position. So maybe that's the advantage of just keeping it on. It's like when I turn the steering wheel, it won't, anyway. Stop bitching, Ty, just get loaded. Nobody gives a shit. So draw a line there for new directions up to Odessa. Now, do I make this real easy? I mean, I could just take 83 up to 20, and I may have to. At least 83 up to 10. Actually, I just found my route. If this was the first load of the episode, I would probably take 83 277 through Del Rio up that way. However, I am going to take 83 north to I-10 west. So we're going to come out up here. We're going to take 10 west to... And then we're going to take 277 turns into 87. Have no freaking clue. So I'm going to put 277 into 87 in San Angelo. Then we're taking 87 north to I-20 west. Once we get on I-20 west, actually we don't even have to get on I-20 west. We can stand that frontage road. All right, so to I-20 west, but I'm gonna put at I-20, stand frontage, waste management on right. And then if we make it to the 338 loop, wow, they actually marked a loop on for a city. But yet over here in where was it, Victoria, Lufkin, that loop's not marked. All right, I know, I'll stop nitpicking, sorry. It's just little shit in the details that make the difference, you know what I mean? There's a lot done in this game that's freaking lazy. Lazy ass development is what it is. Oh, but hey, we have better ambient sounds coming up in the 1.47 update, so there's that to look forward to. All right, I think we're good. And I need fuel. I did not to look at that on the map. So we're there. I mean, we have 477 miles to go. Oh, well, I can hit that one right there before 277. If I remember. I'm going to need to hit fuel at some point, though, because I've only got 431 miles range. Anywho. It's 3:29, so it took us an hour to get loaded. What the hell's going on up here? I don't think that trailer's supposed to be hooked to that truck like that. Real good thing I'm not going that way. How the hell did he even manage to do that? Okay, so that sign over there says 283. Now, I just came out of here. I'm right here. Oh, perfect. Follow the signs, Ty. And I'm in the wrong lane. Luckily, there's no traffic. I don't know why I second-guessed myself. I had written down 83 north, so... and looking over at Sim Dashboard and by what the game was saying, we wouldn't, son of a bitch, really, game? We wouldn't be able to make this in, because it says there's, we have 8 hours and 8 minutes to the destination. And we're gonna get there. Okay, now, thank you. I love how I can shift the same damn time or same way every time. And yeah, so we're gonna apparently get there at 10:43 tonight. What are you giving me a damn ticket for? What an asshole. The hell did I do wrong? My lights are on. My wipers are on. I had my blinker on. The hell? Prick. Large drink for a dollar. 77. Now we want I-10 west. We want 277 later. I'd like to ask this guy what the purpose of his X straps are on the back of his load there. Because I guarantee he's not taking off fast enough to make that load shift backwards. I mean, but bottom line is it's his load, so that's what he wants to do. That's what he wants to do. This time, the more we are going to be super illegal. I mean, to the point where it's ridiculous. Which, looking at the clock, I think we've already busted our drive time, actually. I don't know how long it took us to get loaded. Or unloaded. Still have 6 hours to get there. Oh, that's why I got fined, because my headlights weren't on. All right, fair enough. My comments about him still stand, though. Especially because a jackass was behind me. Area back there was the one I should have pulled into. now we need 277 north. Stopped at that pilot and shut down. Or actually, it's probably a Flying J. Anyway, pilot, Flying J, same freaking difference. Ladies and gentlemen, so what's going to happen here is I'm already at an hour and 3 minutes recording, so we're going to shut down. What was the time? 20:35. All right, so we're going to shut down. G_set time 06:05. Watch your eyes. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, episode 21 comes to an end. We'll finish this delivery in the next episode. If you made it this far, I appreciate you. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. And don't forget to drop a like on the way out. And until the next one, y'all take care. Bye.